We have been doing mineral processing of runoff mine ore for last 2 days. So now the concentrate is on the, usually the number in the last session is small, that is the concentrate. So people who are sitting after concentration, so the value is really here now. So I think it's a great occasion for mineral engineers to have such senior people. And another particular thing that impressed me is many senior people, they sit through both the sessions, and mostly the CMDs, Tripathis have. So this is a very good occasion for both the associations to develop Hyderabad chapter as a model chapter, because morning also we were discussing. The more I look at mineral industry, the more challenges that are there. I think the challenges are innumerable, because starting from the first particle that enters into a mineral processing, we don't know its size, we don't know its shape, we don't know its specific gravity, even if it is 63% or 60% iron. One particle might be 65 and another less silica, so in the same size. So I think mineral processing is very, very challenging. The more muck the mining engineers produce, the more challenges to mineral industry. And I am sure, I think we should stop this compartmentalization, geology, mining, mineral processing, and metallurgy. I think all four have a very combined role to play. So far we have been working in isolation. I think a time has come that we have to have that means even syllabus has to be changed. Burmasa was discussing with me for last 2-3 months. I think we have to have the other day I was talking to a mining engineer in one of the iron ore plants. He's from School of Mines. He said, sir, first year we have no interest to attend classes because wo sab pada hai hamara school days. So teachers are themselves are not updated. This is the problem. I think we have any other engine, if somebody asks me to identify engineering discipline which has most challenges, I would consider it to be mineral industry. Mineral industry is like a human body. Two eyes, all that, all humans are same, but each individual is different. I think this is the most challenging field, and we can really excite the boys, because starting from pressure from our mouth up to every heart, cyclone is hot. So the whole thing is so interlinked from your mining. Because today I have eaten jalebi, evening I may eat something, so you might give different inputs to the human body. So how it digests, how it concentrates, how the heart works. So I think mineral industry is like a human body. Very complex, but it still works. I think there are so many challenges. I think a future generation of youngsters, if we really give it challenging things, I think they would opt for mineral industry. I am fully confident. We have not thrown challenges at them. I think that is the role of teachers. I think that's, again, I would, you know, like our Hyderabad chapters to take a lead on human resource. I think this is most important thing. Environment, rules, regulations. Even if you put a building, you have to get environmental clearance. If you put a dam, you have to get environmental. Nothing special for us. I think these are all, for me, are we have to put up with it anywhere in the country or anywhere in the world. But how to treat, as I was, we were discussing, I was very happy, sir, and you gave. See, we, our aim should be, because all of us know, ores are site-specific and unique in their character, and they are also non-renewable. So these two are, there is no other resource except mineral. Of course, oil is also like that, but I am not going to fuels, I mean liquid fuels. So site-specific, finite and non-renewable. Tell me any other natural, don't talk about human beings, any other natural resource which has these three very, very peculiar characteristics. So a person associated with mineral industry is a custodian of a resource which is finite, which is site-specific, and which is non-renewable. Very fantastic challenge. So how do we, that is the discussion, I think I am very happy Chaudhary Saab gave an example. Every day new challenges are coming, and new technologies, and the problem with our mineral industry has been, particularly mineral engineering industry, just like these doctors don't have time to read books. So the medical representative goes and says, sir, this is a new tablet, it is a miracle drug. So medical representatives are educating the doctors. And similar things are happening in mineral processing also. Equipment manufacturers have taken over. Sir, spiral lagao, Flotex lagao, O lagao. We are not even understanding what is the pathology report of the ore. I would like to plead with all of you, please give very significant importance to pathology report, I call it. That's where geologists have to play a very great role. Depending on that, mining engineers have to be, we should not ask them, give me this kind of grade. Then mineral processing engineer. And I think we have to fight with metallurgists. So far they have been, I know many senior metallurgists might not be here, they might not agree with me. So far they have become customers, which is not correct. We should not be meeting the metallurgist requirements. This is, as I said, it is finite, site-specific, non-renewable. Let the metallurgists do some R&D and innovate so that I don't lose even one grain of the value the nature has given to us. That is one more point. Another thing is, I feel India is going to play a very major global role. I think that India problems in India, all that are irrelevant. Because many companies, Vedanta, Birla, Tata, now NMDC, the other day chairman made a, I think Rajan and Nandan Saab are going this evening. So I think, let us forget about any problems in India. I think we should be prepared to occupy a global and play a global role in mineral industry. I think that's where I see. Just like in information technology. But information technology couldn't become something like Google or something big. We just ended up serving it. But the brain power, the number of people, the future, so many organizations in this country, I am sure India is going to play a global role in mineral industry. So if we aim very high and if we can dream something big, I am sure mineral engineers or mineral industry of the country, because Americans don't do beneficiation. We have been doing beneficiation. Beneficiation of coal, Jamshedji Tata put it, no, he had good quality coking coal, why he put a washery? So we have to admire those people. That means they were conscious of the conservation. I think that is where, I think even if I have to spend, my profit has to come down by 10%, I would rather spend that for conservation. That's how this was explained. I think mineral industry, for me, the more I interact with youngsters, see the problems because I have been as a consultant. Go, the even for the same more, six foreign people are giving six different fellowships. The ignorance is infinity. But problem is so simple. If we analyze good pathological report. So with that, I don't want to give a long lecture. Again, I think we salute NMDC for all that. Very senior people, they come and sit. This is a very unique thing. And then, as I have told in the beginning, mining can be viable. Metallurgy could be economically feasible only if mineral process people play their role properly. So I don't want to take too much time. There are very three distinguished speakers. We came to a gentleman's understanding. Dr. G.V. Rao being the keynote, he will take 30 minutes. Next two will take 20 minutes each. And being a teacher, I'll press a bell as soon as the time is over so that we can have some good discussion. Again, I want to say India is going to play a global role in mineral industry.